One of the key things we believe and we see is that the business of our customers, our peers, is going to evolve into what we call business platforms that are all interacting across the different participants of any given ecosystem, but also across the various areas. And well, the key thing that is going to be enabling this is, first of all, data, and second of all, of course, the sovereign data exchange between all these parties. This is why we have been working for quite some time now with IDSA in defining on how we can support ecosystems and different participants in these ecosystems to share data in a way that we understand exactly who is sharing with whom, having a trust built. And trust means in very, very many ways something that can actually be proven. And proven is what we have, for instance, described in the IDSA reference architecture. And you may notice my innovative approach to PowerPointing in Corona times. We had so many people who were working on these specific topics that all said we are completely busy in, oh, sorry, that's the wrong slide, in helping our customers at this point in time, that we were not able to, that I was not able to build a new set of slides. And I'm just trying to figure out on how to change the, here we go. So in all this, in my innovative way, I just stole the slides or the graph out of the IDSA reference architecture model. One of the key things that we all know and that we notice is that next to the process of finding somebody who is certifying a given provider or different specific data source or sync, it is also needed that we have the technical capabilities in order to prove this is the guy, the device that is actually providing the data with the necessary level of trust. And there's two key elements to that. And one is that of a certification authority that is working with the certification bodies to actually issue the proper, but technically, you see this here in the bottom, it's X509, that is issuing the certificates both to applications that may be very, very high level providing output out of a database, out of a business support system, but also out of devices, out of sensors that actually provides where there are actually eventually millions of these devices that also provides data into our sharing economies. And the one thing I will just briefly introduce is what we are doing, what we are providing in terms of services on the one hand side to issue the certificates through the mechanisms around certificate authorities, but also through a distribution of the process on how to issue these certificates along a tree of providers, and how to also distribute them, and very, very specifically to distribute them if you have a scenario where you have thousands or 10,000s or 100,000s of devices, like you very, very typically have in IoT type of scenarios. So, and I will jump back to my browser, because what I'll just do is I'll give you a brief glimpse into what we're doing with the CA and PKI directory services and revocation services, with a very, very specific point that we, as I mentioned before, work with the different hierarchies of such a trust structure to provide a model where it's not only a central body that will actually be able to issue and distribute all these certificates, but that we also have a model where one can become an intermediate authority that is supporting this process. So when we were talking in the Gaia Xbox on Neurofeel, all of the elements actually have this element of trust at the end of the IDA connectors in terms of a certificate, and a mechanism or the product that I'm trying to show that is implementing this mechanism provides the capability to distribute the issuing of the certificates. This is something we've been working with. I think Andreas talked briefly about the launching coalition. We are building operating models on how to do that. Also how to do that, not only just as an ATOS is providing these kinds of services. We're working, discussing, for instance, with Telecom, how we can make that a truly federated service. So all of these ecosystems are not bound to any specific provider of these kind of capabilities, but that also the underlying trust mechanisms, the underlying distribution mechanisms can actually be federated across different providers. When we talk about ecosystems, you want to have this aspect of freedom of choice, freedom of different providers. And as I said, one of the first companies we are working with is Telecom to provide this as a joint kind of activity. I'd like to, one final word is in providing, is enabling certification and trust services for IDSA. I like to focus on one aspect is if we have devices like vehicles, this is one of the examples you would find on this on our webpage, for instance, or IoT devices, it's really thousands, 10,000, 100,000, or for instance, in smart edge kind of scenarios, millions of devices. There's a specific capability and a specific set of products that we're integrating with the IDSA architecture. It's called Horus, which has the capability to issue the certificates really specifically to all these many of devices. And with that, hope it wasn't too product specifically, but I think, as I said, my topic is enabling IDSA to deliver the services that you've seen at the beginning, like Neurofeel or the Gaia Box. I hand it back to Andreas for the Q&A.